Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to make floating window in Sketchware Pro. Step 1. Download floating window more blocks from my projects store. Click on search blocks, then search floating. You will get all floating window more blocks. You have to download 3 more blocks. Floating window on, click on active and more block. Make sure you download more blocks which are published by 786 Studios. Now open a new project in Sketchware Pro. Click on permissions, then search alert. You will get a permission system alert window. Click on this permission. Now add the downloaded floating window more blocks into this project. Now open on create event and put on active more block. Now go in view section and add a button and change its text to show floating window. Now put the floating window on click more block inside on click event of button. Now open floating window more block. Here we have to define our floating window. Inside block number 2 you can see a custom view which is named as pop-up. It is the name of floating window. You can make the custom view with the same name or you can change the name inside the code. I am changing it to my window. So now I have to make a custom view with the same name. Here I am making a custom view with the same name, my window. Now here you can make the floating window. You can add all linear layouts and all widgets that you want in your floating window. Here I am adding 3 image views to minimize, maximize and close floating window. Now change the ID names of image views: IMG min, IMG max and IMG close. This is very important because if you have 2 widgets with same ID then the code will show error. So all widgets should have unique ID name. Now open floating window more block. Here you will see a code. This is very important. This code builds the widgets inside floating window. It is very important. Without this code, the widgets will not work properly inside floating window. I have three image views, one seek bar and one text view in my floating window. So I will build three image views, one seek bar and one text view with this code. Make sure you keep the ID names of image views and all items same. Here I am making three image views, IMG min, IMG max and IMG close. Whatever widget you want to add in your floating window, you have to build it like this to make it work properly. Now open block number 3. Here you will see the functioning codes of image view, minimum, maximum and close. Here you can see the function code of IMG min. When IMG min is clicked, it will set the width and height of floating window to 90 and 90 pixels. You can change this to whatever size you want. Now image view close, IMG close. When it's clicked, it will close the floating window. When IMG max is clicked, it will set the width and height to the maximum that you enter here. You can always change this to whatever size you want. Now add a add source directly block below the image view functioning codes block. Now you need to add the functioning codes for your floating window. So you have to make the same setup as you did in the floating window, like I am setting the seek bar and text view. Here I have kept the ID same as the floating window. Inside my floating window, the seek bar is seek bar 1 and text view is text view 1. So I kept that same here. Now you have to add the functions. You can add it easily by blocks. Like on start tracking, I will show toast start moving. On stop tracking, I will show a toast stop. Now the functioning is done. Now I have to copy the source code of this. So go to the source code, and here you have to go to the main activity.java. Here you will see all the codes of main activity. Here you can see all the views that are available in main activity, and below that there are function codes of that views. The function code of button view and the function code of seek bar. You need to make sure that you copy only the functioning code that you need. When you see these two brackets, that means the code ends here. That means we need to copy from seek bar till these two brackets. This is the code that we need from seek bar 1 to these two brackets. Just copy this code. Now you can remove these widgets because we don't need them anymore. We got our code. Now open floating window more block and paste this code in the empty at source directly block. Our floating window is now ready. Now save and run the project. After installing and opening for the first time, when you click on the show floating window button, it will open this activity where it will ask floating window permission. So click on it to allow floating window to work. Now click again on button and you will see the floating window. This is just the demonstration of how this floating window works. So when you make it, you can make it look much better than this. Now when I click on image min, it will minimize the floating window. On click on image max, it will maximize, and on click of image close, it will close the floating window. Now the functioning system. When I start moving the seek bar, it will show toast start moving. When I stop moving it, it will show toast stop moving. This is how you can make any function inside floating window. This is the proper method of making floating window. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned everything about floating window. I will keep improving the video quality and voiceover quality in my videos. So please subscribe and like this video.